So Evernote have some new artificial intelligence technology, and we're going to be overviewing in this video, as well as a little bit more into some of their more recent updates and talking a little bit about how AI can be used in Evernote at the current state of affairs. Now, we're going to be demoing this, and it will maybe give you an idea of whether Evernote's right for you, but it also might be giving an idea for those existing users of how to use it. So hello everyone, my name is Francesco. If you're new here, subscribe. But largely, we've got a brand new newsletter. It's called Setups, and it's a very interesting one to me because what we're doing with it is covering what apps and tools people use, as well as routines. So we're picking somebody from a specific industry, maybe a founder or a SEO expert or maybe a teacher, and profiling what apps they use to get things done. So that's going to be a new segment. The newsletter will be below. I think you'll like it because we'll publish a new setup every single week, honing in on somebody of importance that we think will be interested in covering. So I'm going to show you first, more recently, the AI edit ability. This is a new feature that was previously called AI Note Cleanup, and that was available in last summer. But largely, this new feature, what it basically does is it helps to clean up what you're writing. So I used it here and I selected the text and pressed AI edit and I used the summarize function. Now what you can do is summarize paragraph, extended, bullet, micro, turn it into an email. And you can also fix the typos, help you write it, create an introduction conclusion based on it. So in this case I could press conclusion, and what it might do is take core factors as part of that. And as you can see in conclusion, and you can copy and you can paste it. It's not really anything massively new. And that's because by the looks of it, according to their release, AI Edit uses a third-party API to generate results. And I wonder what that third-party API is. So I can imagine it's obviously OpenAI. Well, I can't say it's obviously OpenAI. It's probably OpenAI. And it's very interesting because obviously that data isn't trained apparently, which is, I think, the going situation with OpenAI. So this is a newer feature. It's rolling out in this version. There's some other stuff you can do with it they haven't fully released, like change tone. So basically this feature will be available, but basically it'll just change the tone of the piece. I found a feature quite useful, like this one, help me write the title. And what it will do is, it based on that piece of text, it's actually going to create the title. And up here, I can then go and change it and make it a little bit more refined. As you can see, it brings in some of the HTML. Maybe that's because it's on it's in beta. And I can start to tidy up the note largely. So if I were to maybe do this, I could summarize. I can even extend it if I want to. And it's just what you would typically get inside of ChatGPT. In this case, apparently it's too short to be summarized. So again, I think you have to select a considerable amount of text to do that, in which I did below. Now, this AI feature is available on every note. Not really anything massive, in my opinion. Some of the more recent things that Evernote have finally released, slash command, the ability to actually quickly add all of that, like note links, tasks, calendar events, quite easily with that slash command. and also headings. I believe you can do heading collapsing now, so that now is collapsible. So if I want to tuck that under all under that heading, then I can do. So that's a very small, neat feature. And they're also releasing something called, so if you go to this view, isn't available for me yet, but this calendar mode is much more of a view, if that makes sense. So I can, if I have any calendar events, then I can see and start a note on each of them. But this function tasks will be its own window as well. They're also looking at whether they can organize it based on other attributes like projects and stuff like that. They're also working on something called files, which I was pretty interested at because it sort of separates out all of the files that you have inside of Evernote into its own sort of function, which is a nice feature. So Evernote have an interesting optionality with this. The additional AI ability that they have right now is something called AI powered search. And as you can see, it's in beta. I actually have used it. I don't know why this prompt's coming up. But if I were to say something like, So there's a few AI-powered commands that you can use. There's some that are prompted here, like what's your flight number, but you can be very sort of generative with it in terms of prompting. And here's one, show me my notes with attachments. The AI-powered recommendation doesn't come up, but some notes come up that do have a attachment. So there are some different ways to do it. In my opinion, from using it, I've had very patchy results, and it hasn't been as impressive as I thought it would be. So very interesting, Evernote is sort of playing around with artificial intelligence. And I think that that structural implementation of artificial intelligence, like the ability to reorganize your notes, bring notes together to make most sense into bundles, bring notes into the homepage to make them more accessible, is much more useful functionality than stuff like AI edit, in my opinion. So I think the more they focus on that, the better it will get. And I think it's very interesting to see when Evernote released their new Microsoft Outlook integration, they put a lot of particular focus into the wording around how you could become Evernote could become a scheduling tool for tasks and calendar. So I thought that was very interesting because as a whole, they're trying to utilize tasks and calendar more. And it's very interesting to see that could be an interesting competitor with artificial intelligence to other apps like Reclaim or Motion and things like that. But very early days, bold statements. So hopefully this overview gave you an idea of whether AI edit is useful. Please do let us know if you have any questions. But of course, feel free to dive into our feature, setups, and you'll find and explore other people's productivity tools. So I'll see you there. Thank you very much, folks. Cheerio.